I'm Pascal Lecoq, and I'm directing the Ecole Jacques Lecoq, and also I'm directing the LEM in Paris called the Laboratoire Study of Movement, and it's our work about set design and movement. I'm seeing him working in that type of work, so I feel it's an experimental thing about space and play. So, it's just a way of working with space, but in a matter of line, and to try to mix the what's happening into the space, like a moving space, into a play. About structure in space, I invite him to the LEM to work with my students and working about a huge filet. We call it a filet. It's like a huge structure into the space in our school. So regarding this research, we find that it would be interesting maybe to open to a bigger space or a bigger work.
We can switch very quick from one situation to another. It does something. It has its own dynamic. The transitions from one thing to another, even when it's really slow or it's really quick, it's like a piece of music, and the audience is. Can I say? Yeah, you don't need to think with your head. You can take in with the body.
He's finding a language to tell stories in a way which is so on a basis that the quality of the story and the quality of the poetry can arrive without that it will be distracted about things. Other things, and the way he did it is in a simple way to make space important, the body important, and the story important.
Wishing me light to one more, rich in hope.
Relative to the background of my own training, which is very, very focused on the space outside, the external space so much, and the influence that any performer might gain from the world around us, rather than going inside ourselves to try to find all the material, I suppose. From my own perspective, you know, emotions, trying to find emotions is very confusing for some actors, certainly for me. But when I look at a tree in the wind, when I look at an elastic band snapping, or if I look at the sea smashing against a rock, what Mr. Lecoq, Jacques Lecoq, called a universal poetic awareness, or a fond poétique commun, it's this universal understanding of this poetic language around us, all human beings, that we just have a simple accord with, and that it sets up resonances in our own bodies. because it's already there in our DNA. I suppose that we are made of the stuff of the universe, so we can relate to these outside elements. And in the same way, this work we're doing in this research with the elastics suspended above our head, it's creating tensions in space, lines, forces, different spaces, which aren't invisible. You know, they're very tangible, and they help me as an actor to know what to do. Because sometimes if someone says to me, oh, you know, this is your character and this is the situation, you know, I can get very confused.
That what we do is somehow sculpting the space, which is a bit, how to say it? There's a famous, famous title of a book by a film director, Tarkovsky, who called his work Sculpting in Time. And what we are doing in a way is sculpting in space and maybe also sculpting in time, which means that instead of having one space that is all the time the same and that well, you might put on some screens or something and then you have another space. Instead of that, we have a space that is extremely flexible, so that with the least effort in energy and time, you can totally change it. And of course, the changes are subtle. It's only lines that change. So a lot is left over for the imagination of the spectator, but still the spaces are really changing. And because it's so flexible, you can really sculpt. So you can really work on a development in terms of space. So it's not only the characters that create intentions, that create dynamics, but it's really also the space that is all the time changing.
During the research, I have moments where I think I have the water, and we're using a stick, and I unexperienced like I am, or searching like what I'm doing, I think the stick is the water. And there you need somebody like Carlos, who is searching for the poetic language of water, and not the the first thing you think of as water. So he's defending the suggestion. This work is a suggestion. So if if I use a stick and it's a stick, then it could be a stereotype. But he wants everything to be upside down. And then you get into a part where just a floating thing could be water. And if there is a suggestion in theater, I think the audience has a job and they will finish it.
This work that we are doing here is continuing searching in this direction, the space and the body in the space. That is bigger than emotions, and that gives us the possibility to be in different layers of emotion, but not playing it. This is what we are really in when we are working it now, and I'm so glad for that.
Little by little, I start to keep researching and I start to find how the space, by the use of lines and objects, was taking a form that start to be construct in the space. So this construction, in a very architectural level, people could relate very quickly, because we all recognize the spaces of a church, of the spaces of our ordinary life. So then I could see that in an empty space that is construct, all the feelings can be suggested. because the thing that the audience experience for sure is the space.
Find out this another dimension, which I will call it like because of is the title of the work of Carlos is Manifiesto Poético. I think that dimension we are looking for is a poetic dimension, and we do different exercises with the body, with the voice, with music, and for me, which is I discovered these days is like a kind of extra super consciousness. Normally when you're on the stage you are conscious of yourself and your text and already busy with different things, but it looks like you are anyway in this frame, and here is like boom, suddenly all your senses has to be open for this another extra dimension.
I see a lot of relationships both between this work and music itself, and between this and my life as a singer and performer. Musically, the dynamics are essential to the energy of the piece, and when we're working on this, it is very much like a musical composition in that they're creating phrases with punctuation and brackets, and there's an energy, and more the people learn to feel when the phrase should be finished or when it needs an extra pull or a counter movement. It's a lot like music in that way, especially contemporary music, because we don't have the traditional forms. As a singer, it's even more closely related, I think, because of the physicality of the work and the awareness of how you are functioning on stage in relation to the other people and to the image that's created by the elastics. Because you are not needed to create a whole universe onto yourself, because the role of everyone is creating this expansion for you. And as a singer, that is very helpful to be aware of, because we realize that the more extraneous gestures that we have, the more we take away from the essence of the music. So one well-placed gesture or focus can be much more valuable also in singing. And also just the sheer physical awareness of how much it can add or detract from the music that you're actually performing.
But within this abstraction, it's allowing us to go back to the things that we all recognize, you know? So for example, how we approach from the space point of view, how we approach the text, how we approach emotions, how we approach music, dance. So this is a little bit the journey that I did, if I try to explain shortly.
In our place, we didn't work with a real theme, theater theme or a play. We worked with for example, Dynamic of Colors or Dynamic of Passion, something more abstract, more provocative. Like a word or a passion or something like this. Here in this work, it's more written already. So the filet is became really a frame for the play. It's like a set design in movement, where the actors are involved into the set. So are moving the set in a way. In our school, we find that we call it équilibre du plateau. So it's a little bit like an Équilibre du Plateau, but in three dimensions. So we've got this relation. So we find out this in Paris, and here you've got the same. The actor has to be sensitive to the space around them, but also the up, the down, the background, everywhere. So it's a macrocosm.
The thing that's interesting about how it frames the space, you can use it like three different ways. You can use it to show the emotion or the attitude, as Carlos says, or you can use it as to frame a picture so you know where you are, as in cinematography, so when you're doing film. And you can also do it for the structure, for the set, to create that space. And to me, that's new. Like he says, it's like a new language, a new way of looking at theater.
I feel sometimes it's like image of like you're working like in cinema.
This is the type of worry is not matter to understand it. You have to handle it. You have to drive with it. You can do with this type of work all. It's incredible. It's like a fairy tale. The fantasy starts to appear immediately and never ends. And never ends. Doesn't have end. I don't know for sure. You can do amazing shows with this type of, because it's the fantasy. It's the poetry. It's the music also. It's a world, plenty of ingredients, you know. It's a world, you have to discover it. And you don't have so time to discover all the world, you know. You have only one life. But it's matter to try and to keep in researching and to more deep in this work.
In the work we've done, it's really exciting because I feel like we've discovered that. We've discovered ways that serve the actor, frame the space, show the emotion, make a set that we couldn't possibly imagine, and it's just in the flash of a moment. So I think that's what I got.
What we are trying to do is to find a new language of doing theater, which is very challenging, and I don't know if we're going to get it. But it's exciting the fact that why not today, that we have everything, especially with technology and we know everything and Google and the information is everywhere, how we can put all this upside down and try to remind to the audience, to us, that we are just what we are.